It's AumSum time.
Hi guys. Can you guess the title of my next video? Hurry up! Write your guess in the comment section below.
How tall can we grow?
I can grow as big as the Eiffel Tower.
Oh, stop bluffing. Height is determined by a number of factors. One of them is our genes. We inherit our genes from our parents. Hence, these genes will make us grow approximately as tall as our parents. In addition to this, factors like nutrition, physical health, hormones, etc. also affect our height. Now, if we grow taller than what we are at present, then we won't be able to support our body structure efficiently. For this, we would require much larger bones, or they need to be made of much stronger material. In addition to this, if we were taller, the amount of blood in our body would be more, thus making it hard for the heart to pump so much blood. Besides this, the Earth's gravity constantly pulls us down. As a result, it prevents us from getting taller. How do antacids work?
They don't work. They are unemployed.
Ugh, you are unbelievable. When we eat food, our stomach secretes hydrochloric acid. This acid helps to digest food. However, sometimes when excess acid is produced, it rises from the stomach and reaches the esophagus or throat, causing acidity or heartburn. Now, in order to neutralize the acid, we take an antacid. Antacids work on a simple chemistry principle. Acid plus alkali produces salt and water.
Dude, I'm really weak in mathematics.
Don't worry, I'll explain it to you. Antacids contain alkalis, like calcium carbonate or aluminum hydroxide. When we take an antacid, the alkali reacts with the hydrochloric acid present in our throat and stomach, forming salt and water, and thus neutralizing the acid. In this way, antacids give us relief from heartburn or acidity. Topic: atmospheric refraction. Why do stars twinkle?
Because they blink their eyes.
Nah. The twinkling of stars is due to atmospheric refraction. Atmospheric refraction is the bending of light caused by the Earth's atmosphere.
I thought atmospheric refraction is the bending of my body due to Earth's atmosphere.
Oh, please listen. Earth's atmosphere is changing continuously. When the light of a star travels through space towards us, the continuously changing Earth's atmosphere refracts or bends the light by different amounts and in different directions every moment. When the atmosphere refracts more starlight towards us, the star appears bright, and when the atmosphere refracts less starlight, the star appears dim. In this way, the amount of starlight reaching our eyes increases and decreases, causing the star to appear twinkling. Topic: concave mirror. Why is your reflection upside down on a spoon? Wow. Looks like you're getting ready to go for a party. Why don't you stand here and then look into the spoon? Don't worry. Your image appeared upside down because of the inward curve of the spoon. The surface of the spoon, which is curved inwards, acts like a concave mirror. You look confused. Let me explain. A concave mirror is a mirror whose reflecting surface is curved inwards. Being curved inwards, it reflects or bounces back the light rays in a different manner. When you see yourself in a spoon, which is like a concave mirror, the light rays from your face fall on the top of the spoon and get reflected downwards. While the light rays from your feet fall on the bottom of the spoon and get reflected upwards. As a result, you see yourself upside down. Now, the point where all these light rays meet is called the focal point. When you stand beyond this point, only then will you be able to see an inverted image of yourself. However, if you stand before the focal point, the image will look upright.